Breast cancer is a common disease in the United States and Europe. 1 in 8 American women will have breast cancer during the course of her lifetime. And for most of these women, we actually don't know what causes it. But over the last 2 decades, we have begun to chip away at the unknowns in terms of causes. And the major genes to be discovered about 20 years ago were called BRCA1 and BRCA2, which, when they were mutated, were strongly associated with a high risk of breast cancer. And these were genes that were discovered in families that just had too much breast cancer. Instead of a 1 in 8 kind of probability, it might be every woman in the family would get breast cancer young or would get ovarian cancer. Very important to note that BRCA1 and BRCA2 are normal genes that everybody has. Their role when they are functioning normally is to repair damage in our DNA. Some people have described them as a molecular spell checker. And you can imagine that if they're not working, your DNA might acquire a lot of mistakes. One of the things that we know is that BRCA1 and BRCA2 are not the whole story. There are still families with way more than their share of breast cancer, where it's not 1 in 8 women in the family, but maybe 1 in 2 women who are getting breast cancer. And yet, when we test their BRCA1 and BRCA2 genes, they're perfectly normal. So BRCA1 and 2 are not the whole story. So many mysteries still, even though we've sequenced the human genome. But with that sequencing has come some exciting new technology that allows us to interrogate people's genes more cheaply in larger volumes. And so just over the last 2 or 3 years, we've begun discovering and routinely testing more genes than just BRCA1 and BRCA2, which are associated with breast cancer risk. So if we test a woman, let's say she has a BRCA1 mutation, a famous example of someone who does would be Angelina Jolie, and she's been quite open about that. There really are 2 categories of ways to manage cancer risk in a woman with a BRCA or other high-risk mutation. One would be through strategies of cancer prevention, and the other would be screening or early detection. Knowing your family history is absolutely essential, not just your mother's family history, but your father's family history. Something that a lot of people don't know is that these gene mutations can be inherited equally from the male side as the female side. I certainly hope that we will make rapid progress with understanding the human genome. I believe that we are. I think even in the last 18 months in my field of cancer genetics, we've seen dramatic advances of expanding the genes for which we test beyond just BRCA1 and BRCA2. So that's very exciting. The challenge at this point is interpreting it, is explaining it, understanding what we're finding. I think knowledge is accumulating rapidly, and I think that will only continue over time as our knowledge grows.